maybe any questions again for either Harrison or Crystal. If you will turn in your binder to financial section and go to page one. This is a report prepared by Stephanie. It's our mid-year financial report, some of which Harrison and Mark have already touched on. There are numbers indicated on this that I'm going to just highlight. We're not going to go into all the details of it, but just if you will pay attention to this over the report as it's presented, and we'll get a little bit deeper into some of the projections. Item listed there, number one, both motor vehicle and ad valorem. Harrison has already talked about that. That's dropped nearly $400,000 and hasn't increased significantly. And that Harrison's already commented on the historical rate of our local option sales tax, but the decline that we've experienced in years and the removal of vehicles has a significant impact, since there has been some uptick in the economy as far as automobile sales are referenced. Is that?
Well, I wish I could have gotten that commodities report that I gave you last year, but when I went to pull it up, it was the same one I had last year for 2015. But they haven't posted it yet, because I really wanted to see, I told you last year what the reductions were, but I couldn't tell you where the rise was.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll come out with that and we'll figure out where it's coming from. Obviously, a lot of new cars would be involved. That would be significant, because that's a lot of sales tax being collected.
Item number three there is our probation numbers. That line item fell off in 2017. Y'all know that we're involved now in our in-house probation department. We believe those are going to be beneficial to the county, and I have high hopes, as I indicated to y'all at the meeting where we introduced Felicia Roundtree, that department will be, I believe, much better managed and therefore an increase in our revenue. Prisoner housing, item number four, as of July 1, the sheriff increased that daily rate for prisoner housing, and it is anticipated that that will increase revenues, or we will have fewer inmates, so that it could be a reduction in that jail cost. That number has been up and down. I think we were all very pleased to see those numbers drop off. I think it's been a joint effort on behalf of the judicial committee that Clay and Commissioner Evans were involved in, along with all the judicial members, as well as since the Sheriff Falk has been in. We've seen those numbers reduced, but it is like so many other things, it's cyclical and it just bounced back up, but not back to the level it was. Yes, sir.
Quick question. And then, prison housing, do we anticipate any relief or reimbursement from FEMA? From the IRMA and all?
I know it's. We have filed or in process, but that's a long way out. I'm hopeful that we'll get some reimbursement, but I am not counting on it. If we do, it's going to be great, but we have no reason to anticipate it. We're only just hoping.
We're all qualified, but if they run out of money before they write our check, then they say, so sorry. It's school gets qualified, but there's no money. So they could run out. And we're behind all Puerto Rico and all that stuff as far as the pot goes.
How'd you know where we are in the process of seeing?
On the
city's been reimbursed.
It's money starting flowing in, but we got members for reimbursement.
On page two, item five, the animal shelter fees, they continue to decline slightly.
And they're going to continue to decline, and we'll talk about that tomorrow.
So, something to at least be aware of. We'll skip over to page five. You'll note that item six, the Board of Elections, is down significantly over the last two mid-year reports. And on page six, the IT projects, those projects took, we took those one-time items and developed a project line item out of the regular IT budget where that reduced where ITS has normally been at mid-year. Those include those projects, Clay, that we were talking about the other day, the court and the public safety software. That is an ongoing process that is a necessity that we are taking gradual steps in funding that. On page eight, that's our item number eight, is our contingency line item. That in-house probation office is where we've left some of the costs there for contingency as part of the budget process, and that's where we'll be using those funds. Over to page 11, you'll notice item number 9, the total share costs are down significantly from the same time last year or prior years. Had a conversation with Sheriff Falk last week, and based on his expectations, he is still going to be utilizing the ICE team, I believe, as far as continuing to work with interstate and so forth on the road safety.
Yeah, that was one of the auditor questions, why the drug fund money had gone way up. And I just emailed back that we had a new sheriff in town.
I think we got, about $5,000 in total and several seizures that came through
the
court.
It's all been in the press.
Over the past week. Like, we got some new stuff this week.
If you would skip over to page 16. This too is related to the Sheriff's Department is commissary. Those revenues have increased from last year, while those expenditures are below the 2017 levels. And following that same pattern on page 17, the jail operation fund expenditures are below prior year levels as well. On page 18, the 9/11 charges, this is for the prepaid cards. These, as Harrison indicated, are collected by the state and then remitted to the local governments for prepaid wireless. Those fees are down for local governments. We're hoping that this legislation we already touched on will be a significant improvement, I'm hoping. But
are we being treated fairly on that?
I don't know one has. There's a problem with both ends. The landline and wireless come direct from AT&T or whoever, but there's no oversight to see how they're determining those numbers, and I would assume the same's with the state. Well, as far as that goes, a part of the revenues and the sales tax, we don't know which they got it at. There just doesn't seem to be any system in place.
There's no auditing system actually that's in place to be able to verify that the numbers are correct, that we're remitting the correct numbers.
I'm very hopeful that the General Assembly's answer to the 911 is not similar to their answer about TABT. So I hope they won't say, don't worry about it, we're going to fix it for you, as they did with
Berkeley Tax. Keep in mind that your landlines continue just to drop more and more every year. People are just saying, I'm using a cell phone, everybody's got a cell phone.
On page 19, the 911 operations and the public safety radio, those 2017 expenditures are higher than normal at the mid-year point, but they are back closer to the 2016 levels, at least so far. And page 27, this is the first full year of the contract for water and wastewater services with Moody Air Force Base. You'll see that note there, item 14. And this is an item that y'all will discuss later in this retreat process. But on page 30, item number 15, that solid waste host fee, the revenues continue to decline from year to year. So we have this information that I've just reviewed listed in your packet, so you will be able to go back through this and give a little more attention to it. If you'll turn to page 32, you will note a breakdown on the mid-year from 2010, FY 2010 to FY 2018. You'll see our number of positions has dropped from that time period. But as Harrison has already pointed out, that health insurance and those retirement costs have been a significant increase. Most of the rest of it has, you'll see, has been pretty close in that 8-year period and has remained relatively the same, some cost increase.
Now, salaries have increased.
Yes, they have.
That does not include benefits in the salary.
No, that is, you'll see those.
That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah, those breakdowns about the health insurance and so forth. Y'all have included over that the commission from 2010 to now. There have been some cost adjustments as well as merit increase and cost of living.
Joe, what would be an example of the other benefits? Because it's significantly higher than what it was in 2010. Just the category total other benefits?
Yeah.
I was just curious what that might include.
That's probably solely related to Prince.
Gotcha. Yeah, because I mean, everything else is kind of broken out.
Yeah, I would say based on the percentage of, that's probably related to Prince.
Okay.
If you continue in this process on page 35 and the numbers on 35 and 36, as well as the associated charts, that our tax revenues are the make up the majority of our general fund revenues, and in the past they have declined and have been virtually flat. You remember that 2016 there was a delay in the Board of Assessors which caused the property tax bills to be late, and the commissioners then elected to roll back to the calculated rate, if y'all recall that. We've already again talked about our motor vehicle cost. You also remember that there has been there was a revaluation by the Board of Assessors during 2016, but there was also a large number of appeals that took place, and that resulted in really no significant growth, because a lot of those appeals were just either rolled back to where they were, in some cases, if you recall, were reduced from what they were previously. So I think y'all remember when we paid to have that analysis made by the Board of Assessors.
There's a skew in that, in that the way the accounting works, that's not billed property taxes, just so you understand. If what is recognized is up to 60 days after the end of the year. One thing I think we're seeing with the big increase in FY17, some of that is catch up. There was a higher amount due at the end of 17, and during 17, a lot of that was brought in. So you had more revenue just because of catch-up. But some of it's due to growth, too. So it may be flat or down in FY18, which I've already acknowledged that.
Our other tax revenues have been relatively steady. There's been slight growth each year, but penalties and interest on the delinquent taxes have shown a slight decline. Fine revenues have been declining, but recently they have taken a little upward tick over the past 6 months, and we are hopeful and anticipating that there will be an increase, but again, we're being very conservative in our estimation. I've already mentioned the prisoner housing, that increase, and what we are hopeful of with the adjustment. And you'll again note that more than half of the general fund expenditures are related to personnel costs. For several years, those new positions were limited, and we reduced those. Some are still not back to previous level of positions. Some are still shorthanded, but we again look at that every year with budget request. I think budget request this year, after my initial meeting with Kevin, is that it will not be the significant increase that we have seen, request that we have seen over the last few years, where some departments come in and say 12, 8, 19, those seem to be much more controllable this year. We have looked in our numbers and anticipated your consideration for any type of merit increase, not because we expect or are pushing that as a concept. We don't do that until we get into our budget. Y'all give us direction and consideration for that. But from a financial standpoint, we try to have in the back of our mind what those numbers might look like and what that might entail. So we're just trying to make some guesswork out of our anticipation for positions as well as those benefit costs. We have had some increase in our contracts, utility costs, operation for some of the outside agencies. And you will note if you flip on over, you look at that chart there on page 37, if y'all haven't noticed it yet. That's our property tax. You'll note that Stephanie indicated where we had a reduction, where we had an increase. So we did reduction, increase for 4 years there. This is on page 38 is something that I would like you all to give some consideration to, again, as part of this vision retreat. You'll note on that chart that the blue line indicates that incorporated millage digest and the red indicates the unincorporated, and you'll notice those trends. If you plot this on out, it is reasonable to expect that there would be an intersection or a crossing of those two lines. So it will bear watching over the next couple of years to see, because while ours has increased in the unincorporated area, those decreases in the incorporated area have been significant enough that we've remained almost flat. So the increase has not been significant enough to offset that decline. And I think some of y'all have already indicated that and discussed it. Graph 39 is your, on page 39 is your motor vehicles. Got the local option sales tax as the blue, the red is the motor vehicle, and then of course the TABT. And we've already spent enough time on that topic. It's, the more we talk about it, the less attractive it is. Fine revenue from the general fund from both state court and superior court. You see that there has been, since 2003, a relatively significant drop in those state court fines. They have come back up over the last couple of years, so we will be continuing to watch those numbers.
One of the things that will hopefully help us over the next few years is in April, whenever the new court software is implemented, the first three court will be set up to take partial payments, and Judge Edwards is ready to pull the trigger on a traffic bureau. So one of the things that we've had for years and years are people with significant traffic violations, citations, and fines and fees that have gone on probation. Then whenever you couple that with private probation being poorly managed, we've just left money on the table because there are a lot of cases that have run past the time that the law allows them to be managed, so they basically had to be written off. So with the Traffic Bureau, there's a lot of what before was going heavily through the solicitor's office and on the private probation. population that we were losing. Now, those cases will become civil cases, and Beth will be able to take partial payments, and people, instead of having to be put on probation, can just pay those fines. So we won't see the write-off, nor will we see the costs related to probation management for those fines.
People sit there too, but they won't have to pay probation fees.
Right.
You know? So they just pay the fines. So it doesn't end up like paying less than we're paid under probation. It's just, you know, the county gets all the money instead of going on probation.
Page 41, revenues, expenditures, and fund balance. I think y'all all are aware that the county adopted the policy of maintaining a fund balance that would provide us for 120 days of operating expenses. We are slightly below that now. I think we have 3.5 months of, I think that's one of the most indicated. Just over those 100 days, but if you look back to our previous years, we still are maintaining, while we had some very good years there, 129, 147 days, while this has dropped off some, I'm still pleased that that fund balance has remained as rich as it has. It's not as rich as Clay wants it to be, but it's wondering everything. Yeah.
It's, so you notice that blue line is going the right direction.
That's it.
Well, it also, the blue line drops a lot faster when it starts dropping than it does going back up the other way.
Well, and you know, we've all talked about this over the years, that those revenues, and when you look back in 2004 and 2005 and at that time, we were able to put money in fund balance because of that increase in revenue. So we were able to build up that fund balance during those good days. It's very difficult, and those numbers that you heard this morning, it are significant that we have been able to build up fund balance over the last 2 years. Roughly $800,000+, just under $1 million over the last 2 years, which, again, during the tough economic times that we've had, I'm pleased with those numbers in that direction. Page 42 is just kind of a breakdown on those employees. You'll see where we have been since 2008, those departments that have experienced losses, and obviously the administration, public works, and public safety, especially public works, experienced the greatest impact on those departments. 43, page 43 is still that $3 goes. Some of you may become immune to this, but I think that this is important for us to continue to go back and make ourselves aware of where those costs are. Page 44 is a breakdown on those general fund expenditures. You see the leveling here of the Board of Commissioners.
I have a question about the community support percent. I think it was at 22. I just want to know kind of where we are with it. I know we were able to give Parker and Mrs. Green a lump sum, and I just didn't know how related to the amount of support.
We have been in close contact, the chairman and myself, and now since Paige has become the honorary wing commander. She has been in a position to have close communication with Dr. Lucy. And the chairman has met with and spoken to her about this. Those funds have not been impacted with a lot of expenditures, travel and so forth, they have not traveled to the degree they have in the past. But those funds have been utilized for things like, if you recall, there was a fire and two of the families at Moody lost basically everything. And those, some of those funds were used to assist with that. So I think that while we're not spending as much with travel, we have utilized those funds. And to me, I think a better example maybe than what we have in the past. Do you disagree?
I would agree completely with that.
I agree completely. I was on page 14 and I just see where you spent 22%. I knew we had said we were going to get them like $35,000 or something anyway.
Yeah.
To just to represent us or what have you, mm-hmm. to what they've been doing. But
yeah, we receive written reports on things that are going on at the base, contact information, et cetera, et cetera. Last week, General Zobrist, commander of the 9th Air Force, was at Moody for a two-day inspection. There was a reception hosted by, I believe it was AGAP, and several community leaders were there. The chairman spent a good bit of time as well as Paige talking to General Zobrist. I think he enjoyed talking to Paige more than the chairman. But,
I agree with that.
I thought that was a very important opportunity. The chairman and I had the opportunity to speak with Colonel Valencia, had some in-depth discussion about needs at Moody as far as technology and so forth. We also had an opportunity to speak with the, I believe, the major, over the medical.
Colonel.
And continuing efforts on the P4 initiative and things working with Wiregrass, VSU as far as physical physical therapy for those trainees at Moody and opportunity for them to get some, quote, hands-on experience. So I would say conservatively that subject to our, I mean, including our work with Moody on our, on their solid waste and these other roles, Lowndes County probably has a more pronounced role at Moody than they have probably in my term here, which I think is...
I'll add to it from Dr. Lucy. We get a daily report that Dr. Lucy sends out. Then as well, we get a monthly report of specifically some issues that may be going on that Dr. Lucy and Parker are involved in directly. So the funding that was provided was basically provided to Dr. Lucy and Parker as a consultant, or that was paid for out of Moody support in order to be able to give us a little bit closer insight and have the availability of that resource of knowledge about the history of Moody, about things that are going on. They have to understand as well, I mean, there's a lot of things that they can't share, but then when it's in generalization, they will keep us abreast and we find out issues that may be going on at Moody that we may need to address. Sometimes we can find out about it through that process sooner rather than later, and it being a full-blown issue that we have to try to address and get resolved. Dr. Lucy has her ear to the ground as far as Moody's going and what's going on out there. So it's a huge asset that we have as a community, certainly with Paige's involvement. I know I try to be as available as I possibly can for the folks out there at Moody, Because they are a tremendous asset to this community, and it's a big part that we do need to play. But by doing that, it has improved Lowndes County's personal relationship within the leadership at Moody, in my opinion. You know, if there's an issue going on, we'll get a call for cooperation. We may get a call, just a simple thank you for what you're doing. So those things are extremely important, will continue to be important and viable for this commission, because again, Moody Air Force Base is as has been said, is a huge asset. $450 million a year economic impact. So we don't need to just sit back and think that Moody Air Force Base is always going to be there and that they are the military, they'll take care of themselves. This community for years has been known as a community that works very, very closely with our base, and we need to continue those efforts. So it's all positive. Everything that we hear is positive. Seldom ever is there any issue that's out there that needs to be addressed that you might would say could be a very negative process. But it's all good for the Air Force Base at this present time. Mr. Pritchard, unless you've got anything else before we go to the next chapter in this book, how about a short break?
I want to make one comment. On page 35 and 36, I would encourage y'all throughout the retreat to kind of make yourself familiar with those numbers. You'll see that those projections go out to 2023. Those are just numbers that we have we have utilized as we have with all the other information that you're going to see. Is trying to give you an idea of our projections and what are realistic.
So there you go. I thought maybe you had found a crystal ball somewhere.
No, sir.
All right, let's take about a 10-minute break.